I often get asked what mechanical keyboard I recommend, and I'm always like, I don't know, what form factor are you after? So today we're going to talk about the main different form factors that are available, especially in the pre-built market. In custom mechanical keyboards, it really goes another step further, and there's a heap of variations, so we won't specifically talk about them, but they relate closely to these anyway. So a really quick rundown. We have full size 100%, 1800 compact, 96%, 10 keyless, 75%, 65%, 60%, we'll chuck in 40%, and mention ortholinear and others. And these are what I would regard as the main form factors, and the percentages don't exactly match the actual percentage relative to a full size, it's just what they're called. So let's start off with a classic full size or 100%. And it's really simple. If you absolutely require the numpad and don't want an external numpad, don't want any changes, then this is the one for you. They're obviously widely available with every brand offering one, and if you're an ISO person, you'll have no problem finding one for you. Then we have the 1800 layouts. There's not a whole lot of these, and there's some variations. Probably the most available one would be the Leopold FC980, which is a stunning retail mech. Honestly, one of the best out there. And again, if you require the numpad, then we have it, but in a more compact size, being about 3-ish columns shorter than a full size. Basically, the nav cluster is moved to the top right, which allows us to bring the numpad closer to the left. However, depending on the variation, you may end up losing a few of those nav keys. And our final numpad form factor is the 96%. As the name suggests, it has about 96% of the keys of a full size, but this time, everything is squished together. So it's like the previous 1800, but without any gaps. This saves even more space. However, the disadvantage is that you don't have the separation between the different clusters, and it can be difficult to navigate through, especially when touch typing or even trying to hit the other keys in your peripheral vision. So those are the three main ones with a numpad. Disregarding an external numpad, if you work with numbers, then you probably don't want to go any smaller than those. Alright, now we start getting into the compact keyboards. I have a video on why using smaller keyboards may be better for you, but the main gist of it is that it saves space on your desk, allows more space for your mouse, and brings it closer to the center for better ergonomics. And legit, once you go small, you really notice how big full-size boards are. Keyboards, of course, have two sets of numbers, so if you can live with just the numero, then I highly suggest you try one of these. Starting with the Timeless 10 Keyless, also called TKL and sometimes 80%. Simple really, just a normal keyboard with a numpad chopped off. I personally love the look, it maintains the clustered design for easy navigation, and alongside the full size, it is widely available, and again for ISO users. But below this size, unfortunately the options start to get thin for ISO boards. Next down, and what I think is kind of the middle ground, is the 75%. Typically this has around 84 keys, where a TKL typically has 87, so we essentially get the primary functionality of a TKL, but condensed. There's quite a few variations of this as well, some have no gaps, some have clusters, but the main defining features are that it has dedicated arrow keys and a function row on top. So if you need the F keys, then this is the one for you. Personally, I think a 75% with gaps is one of the best looking layouts and functionally is perfect for me. But usually in the pre-built market, they will have no gaps and some can find it looking quite cramped. Below that, we come to the massively popular 65%. And it's essentially a 75%, but the top row is chopped off. So now we have the base plus the dedicated arrow keys and a few nav keys which can vary. And these usually have like 65 to 70 keys. What makes this so popular is its very compact form factor, but it has the essentials that many need. Personally, this is as small as I can comfortably go because of those dedicated arrow keys. And they look great. Being small and very simple looking, it can really give a minimalist look and kind of like an uncluttered feel at times. It's not as tall as the 75%, so it's a little less squarish looking. There's also quite a range to choose from, even in the budget market, which is great to see, from the likes of Drevo, Durgod, then we have guys like Ducky, Barmilo, and Leopold, and of course there's some really great value lower end customs from KVD fans with a Tadar 68 and Tofu 65. And this is where it starts getting a bit too small for a lot of people, and these are the 60% boards. Still, these are massively popular, especially with the Vortex Poker keyboards in the earlier days, the AN Pros, and more recently the Ducky 1-2 Minis. And they're also hugely popular in the custom world as they're very standardized. But yeah, the biggest thing missing are the dedicated arrow keys. As said, I personally find it difficult to use, and I'm sure it's the same for a lot of other people. And this is where using layers comes more into play. So usually to access the arrow keys, you have to press a function key along with other keys. And that will be the case for all the other missing keys. Sometimes I even program them to be in the bottom right corner, as I don't use those keys often. And again, there's variations that also include arrow keys, but you'll always have to sacrifice something when trying to squeeze them into such a small space. But those are the key words: small space. Tiny boards, amazingly portable, and can be really efficient if your use case allows it. There's an absolute ton of these 60% boards available now. You can get them from like 30 bucks, and the budget end will all nearly be the same thing, as you can't vary that much in case design. The 40% gang. Yeah, bare essentials I would say. I've hardly used them. I've used the Vortex Core just for review and personally found it difficult to use. Of course it takes time as you're going to be missing a lot of keys, so a lot of the stuff will be accessible with key combos on different layers. But if you can use it, then you get an amazingly tiny keyboard that you can literally put in your pocket. You could also argue that you have everything in immediate reach, because even with 60% you have to move a little bit. And just a few mentions, there's ortholinear boards that have keys in a grid rather than staggered, and those are available in a range of sizes. There's split keyboards, which are usually made for ergonomics, and there's variations with every form factor. But I'd say the left-hand numpad would be the biggest variation in regards to actual use. So having a numpad on the left allows you to have more space for your mouse and basically get those ergonomic benefits of smaller keyboards. And it allows you to use the numpad and mouse simultaneously, which is amazing in my opinion. Not too many out there in the pre-built market. I know Bloody Gaming has one, and there's a few customs like the EXT65 I built on the channel, but yeah, that's just an example of variation. And those are the main form factors. As said, if you don't absolutely require a numpad, honestly, downsizing will make a massive difference. It's just so much better, and I'm sure a lot of people will say the same thing, because when you go back to using a full size, it's just so noticeable. So let me know what form factor you run, and possibly if you're thinking of having a change, and hopefully this makes things a little clearer for people just getting into mechs. Also, if you have any questions, chuck them down below. I'll also put a spreadsheet in the description with some of the boards I've dealt with.